Hello everyone, welcome to the video lecture series of Theory of Automata and Formal Languages. We are into unit number 1 we are learning about finite automata. So in my previous video lecture where we have completed the topic about Murray machine and Mealy machine, and we have designed the Murray machine and Mealy machine as well. Okay, now in this video lecture we will look into one example where we will try to convert a given Murray machine to a Mealy machine. Okay. So let's start off with the example. So the example says here that first we have to construct a Murray machine that prints A whenever the sequence is 0, 1. That means here the output will be A and the sequence will be 0, 1. Are encountered in any input binary string and then convert it to its equivalent Mealy machine. So first we have to construct a Murray machine. And I think you can pause the video now as you have already understood the construction of a Murray machine. If anyone has not done or anyone has not viewed that particular video, then you can get back to my previous video where we have done the design process of Murray machine and Mealy machine. Okay, so you can pause the video and you can construct the Murray machine. Then we will. I won't take much time in constructing the Murray machine as you already know about it. Okay, so I got the Murray machine. I think this entire diagram already been done in my previous video, so I think it will be clear to everyone. So, but still, I will explain to you. Okay, what it says is that on seeing a sequence of 0, 1, it will print as A. Okay, it will print as A, and that is what I have tried to bring it out. Okay, 0 initial state is A I have taken. And from A there is a transition 0 and then 1. Okay, and where it is entering, it is entering into the state C and it is printing the output as A, as it has been already explained, correct? Otherwise all other states will have the output as B, because A was the output with the help of which you can directly justify that this is the final accepting state for the string 0, 1. Now as this is a restricted value, so I have done this restriction part. Now apart from other other inputs that is based on 0 and 1, we can have any combination. So initial state at A, I have a transition for 0 but I don't have a transition for 1, so I took a self loop over here. So if I take a self loop, then also it doesn't affect the sequence, that is 0, 1. Okay. Now in between there, so A state is over for both the inputs is 0 and 1, there is a transition. So this is a determinism. Now moving to state B, already we are having a transition for 1 but we are not having a transition for 0. So if I take a self loop in here, that also it will not affect the sequence of 0, 1. See, after 0 it is coming 1 only and it is reaching the state C where we have declared A as the final output. Correct? Then after that, if we look at C, we are not having any input. So we took a input transition for 0 to B. Why? If I do like this, then it will not affect the sequence 0, 1. It will again revert it back to A, to C, where the output is A and the sequence is 0, 1 only. Okay? And for 1, I cannot take a transition over here. So I took a transition to the initial state. Okay? Just hold on. Okay? So this is all about your Murray machine. I think this is already it is clear to everyone. Okay, but still I have shown to you. Okay, now based on this Murray machine, this is the state transition diagram for the Murray machine. Now as I have told you that earlier, I haven't shown the state transition table for a Murray machine or a Mealy machine. Now we will look into the state transition table as well. Okay, so okay, I won't be looking into the language right now. I'll be looking into the diagram and the table. Okay, now looking into the this is the diagram and looking into the table. The state transition table will consist of these particular columns where this will include all the states, input, and for the states, what are the corresponding output. This is the table. Okay, so here we are having three states. So I already made the table for you all. So we can fill up the states immediately. Okay, so I have already get back to the table right now. So if we look into the table, this is already you know about finite automata transition table, right? So state A on seeing 0, on seeing input symbol 0, it is going to state B. Clear? State A on seeing 1, where it is going to state A only, it is perfectly fine. State B on sync 0, it is going to itself, so B. State B on sync 1, it is going to C. Perfectly fine. Then state C on sync 0, it is going to B. Perfectly fine. State C on sync 1, it is going to A. So this table is perfectly fine. Now where what to write down in the output section? See, we need to write down the output in the output section, the output corresponding to these states. So for state A, we are having small letter P. Correct? We are having small letter P. Okay, next for state B, we are having again small letter B only. Correct? So we don't have any problem. Okay, and then for state C, we are having a small letter A. I think it is clear to everyone that how the transition table we have drawn. Now, this is the process. Okay, this is the process you need to follow. From state transition diagram, you have to convert into state transition table. From state transition table, you have to draw the diagram for the Boolean machine, and then finally you can draw the state transition table for the Boolean machine. Now, looking into this particular table, we can draw down the states right now. Okay. Okay, now let us check this. These are the three states I have made, and I have interconnected each of them. Okay, now let us check from state A on sync 0, where it is going to state B. So I will make a 0 transition over here. Okay, I think it is clear. Okay, next state A on sync 1, where it is going to itself only. So I can make a self loop over here. Okay, I can make a self loop, and what is the transition for this? The transition will be 1. Okay, so this is clear. Next we will look into state B. State B on sync 0, where it is going to itself. Okay, it is going to itself. So what is the transition? Transition is 0. Okay, state B on sync 1, where it is going to state C. So this will be your transition for 1. Perfectly fine. Okay, now we are done with state B. Now we move into state C. State C on sync 0, it is going to B. That means we have to make a transition from state C to state B. Okay, and this will be marked as, what is the transition? The transition will be state C to B. Transition is 0. So this will be your 0 symbol. Okay, perfectly fine. Now left out with last one, that state C on sync 1, where it is going to A. So I think the diagram that you got is the same that you have done in your previous one. That means Moore machine. Okay, so this will be your 1 input symbol. I think almost everything is done. And now what we need to mark? We need to mark the output corresponding to the transitions, that's it, in Mini Machine. So if we look into state A, okay, whatever incoming transitions to state A, everything will be marked with what? B. Because why? Because every incoming edges only is coming inside to A, others all going out from A. So whatever transitions which are coming inside A will be marked as input, output as B. So what is the first one? 1. So it will be marked as output as B. I think it is clear to everyone. So this is marked as B. Okay. Next one, if you talk about this incoming edge, so it will also be marked as B. So it is very simple. Okay. Now next one, in state B, for state B, we are having the output as small letter B. So whatever incoming edges are coming inside B, those will be marked as B. Okay. So this is actually conversion of Moore to Mealy is very easy. Conversion of Mealy to Moore is also easy, but a little bit of things we have to keep in mind. Okay. Next is this one. So this one will also be acting as a output as B. Okay. Then this is also output as B. Okay. I think this is done for state number B. Now moving to state number C is having only one transition, and that is 1, and which actually the language explains that this state C is having output as A. So this 1 will be having a output as A, and this is your final transition table for the given Moore machine. transition diagram for the given Moody machine. Now from this you can draw the state transition table. That depends on you, but if you want you can draw it. How to draw? See, the same table you have to draw it, but there will be this output column will be eliminated from this table, and this output column will be associated with every inputs. That's it. For state 0 there will be an output column, for input 1 there will be an output column, and for how to find out, deco that you can look into the diagram. Okay, if you want then I can also show it to you. Let me give you the state transition table for Mealy machine as well. It will be easy for you. So you can check it out. This is your transition table for your Mealy machine. And how to draw, it's as simple as what you have drawn over here. The states will be over here. So A was the initial state. So I forgot to name this. Okay, A was the initial state. Then B and C, these are the states. Now this table is similar to what you have drawn over. And this one, okay, state transition table for Moody machine. Okay, now the state the transitions will be remain as it is. Now if you look into a on seeing zero input, where it is going? B, perfect. And what is the output? B plus. That's it. In this way you have to finalize. A on seeing one, where it is going? It is going to a on seeing one, it is going to itself only with what transition? B. So definitely the output is B. Similarly, B on seeing 0, where it is coming to B with the output as 0, as B, so that is being given. B on seeing 1, where it is going to state C, and with the output is was A, so given. So similarly, C on seeing 0, it is going to state B with output as B. Then state C on seeing 1, it is going to state A with output as B. So this is the final state transition table for your Mealy machine. So what is the process? I think everyone is clear with the process. At first, you have to either you will be asked to construct a Moody machine, or a given Moody machine will be given to you. First, you have to convert that Moody machine into state transition table, and from that state transition table, you can easily draw the diagram as the way I have explained to you. And from that, you can construct the state transition table for the given Mealy machine. So I think everyone is clear with the topic, and this is a very good example of how to convert a Moody to a Mealy machine. In the next video, I will explain to you one more example where we will try to convert a given Mealy machine to a Moody machine based on certain criteria. Okay. Thank you for watching the video, and if you're having any questions or any suggestions, you can comment down below. So also do subscribe my channel to get the updated videos as well. Thank you.